Anyone who says they get enough sleep is probably lying. Thanks to our stressful day-to-day lives and the constant distractions of technology, people are increasingly deprived of the very thing that keeps us ticking. There are plenty of so-called sleep hacks out there, but if you really want to get a good night's kip, just follow these simple steps. Kick the caffeine. This one might seem pretty obvious, but coffee before bed is never a good idea. In fact, according to sleep scientist Matthew Walker, you should still well clear of anything containing caffeine after 2 p.m. if you want to optimize your chances of drifting off in minutes. It seems like a big sacrifice, but there's actually some simple science to back it up. When we wake up in the morning, a chemical called adenosine starts to build up in parts of our brain and creates sleep pressure, which makes us feel tired and drowsy. After about 16 waking hours, the average person will accumulate enough adenosine to make them drop right off. The thing is, coffee, tea, and other caffeinated beverages basically create the opposite effect, which is great if you're pulling an all-nighter, but not so much if you've got an early start in the morning. The average half-life of caffeine is between 5 to 7 hours, which is why Walker recommends avoiding this stuff after 2 p.m. Caffeine works to inhibit sleep by blocking these signals of adenosine and tricking the brain into a feeling of wakefulness instead. The longer caffeine blocks adenosine, the greater the buildup is, which is why when your body finally rids itself of the caffeine, you'll feel like you're crashing harder than before. Choose cherry. If you're feeling bummed out about giving up your evening coffee, don't fret, because I have a great alternative for you. Cherry juice. It might seem like an odd choice, but cherries could be the unsung hero of your precious shut-eye because they're a great source of melatonin, which is a naturally occurring chemical hormone that can help regulate your sleep cycle. When the sun goes down and we get into bed, a pea-sized gland located just above the middle of the brain, known as the pineal gland, begins to release melatonin into the blood. The higher our melatonin levels are, the less alert we become, and the more inviting the idea of sleep seems. In recent years, cherry juice has been viewed as a sort of restorative cure-all, and a strong enough dose of melatonin can even work like a mild sedative. Of course, natural low-sugar alternatives are best, so tart cherry is more likely to have an equalizing effect on your sleep. Instead of having a soda during the day, which is full of caffeine, try making a spritzer out of cherry juice, tonic water, and a dash of citrus. Your brain will thank you. Stay cool. Most people want to feel warm and cozy when they go to bed. But this just in. To get the best night's sleep possible, you should actually cool your body down first. According to Matthew Walker, our bodies require a drop in temperature of about 2 to 3 degrees Fahrenheit or 1.5 degrees Celsius to fall asleep, because temperature has a direct effect on the production of melatonin. If you're constantly waking up to find your limbs sticking out of the covers at strange angles, that's a clear sign that your body unconsciously tried to regulate your temperature in order to sleep better. The ideal temperature for your bedroom, considering your chosen bedding and pajamas, should be somewhere between 65 degrees Fahrenheit or 18.3 Celsius. Walker also recommends an easy trick to reduce your core temperature and fall asleep quicker: taking a hot bath before bed. It might seem counterintuitive, but when you get out of the bath, blood vessels on your skin surface dilate and quickly help to radiate out heat, which causes your core temperature to plummet. According to Walker, hot baths can even induce up to 10 to 15% more deep, non-rapid eye movement sleep in adults, which is one excuse to get a little more me time. Sleep before midnight. Ridding yourself of all distractions and turning the lights off before the clock strikes midnight can sometimes seem like an impossible task. But sticking to Cinderella's rules might actually be the elixir your sleep schedule needs. According to sleep expert Dr. Narina Ramlakhan, the 90-minute period before midnight is one of the most powerful phases of sleep, because that's when the body feels most replenished. It's all down to an area of the brain called the circadian timer that helps to synchronize the movement and function of every cell in the body to levels of light and darkness in the environment. When light levels drop below a certain limit, the circadian timer sends a message to the pineal gland to start producing melatonin, and every cell in the body starts adjusting its functions. This circadian rhythm plays an essential part in regulating many bodily systems, including blood pressure, temperature, and the production of cortisol, the stress hormone that inhibits sleep. Therefore, it makes sense to try and sleep in accordance with that rhythm when the body is at its most balanced and rejuvenated. Ramlakhan also explains that although 7 to 9 hours may be the ideal amount of sleep, it's sometimes the things we think about sleep that prevent us from getting it. Basically, it's all down to quality over quantity. Don't be afraid of the dark. You don't need to tell me that you'll sleep better in the dark. But did you know that darkness is scientifically proven to be a key factor in getting quality kip? You see, modern society deprives us of the same amount of darkness that our ancestors used to enjoy. So it's up to us to create a dark environment that will promote the production of melatonin. Matthew Walker explains that smartphones and other devices that emit blue light can actually trick our brains into thinking it's still daytime, which prevents us from sleeping. Even a dim light of around 8 to 10 lux can delay the release of melatonin in the brain. A subtly lit living room might hum at around 200 lux, which is about 1% the strength of daylight. But that's still enough to have a 50% melatonin suppressing influence on the brain. What does Walker suggest? Dim half the lights in your homes as you settle into your evening routine, and most importantly, put all your electronic devices away at least an hour before bed. That means no more binging YouTube in bed, which is probably what many of you are doing right now. But I'll let you off this one time. One sweet spoonful. We've all heard that you shouldn't gorge yourself on snacks before bedtime, but there is one sweet solution to help you drift off faster. All you need to do is eat a spoonful of raw honey before bed. You might think sleeping equals total rest, but your brain actually uses a lot of energy throughout the night. At any one time, our liver can hold between 75 to 100 grams of glycogen, which comes from sugar, and it's this store that the brain relies on for its much-needed energy. The thing is, your body consumes about 10 grams of that glycogen per hour, which means that for many of us who eat our last meal around 6 p.m. and don't sleep until after 11 p.m., your brain has used up most of its glycogen reserves by the time you actually hit the hay. As a result, halfway through an otherwise good night's sleep, your brain might wake you up as its way of saying, "Hey, mister, I need more energy." A tablespoon of raw honey doesn't only provide the brain with a much-needed boost, but also promotes the production of an essential amino acid called tryptophan, which can assist with mood-boosting serotonin and good old melatonin. Raw honey is also said to be around 22% better at making liver glycogen than pasteurized honey, so make sure you get the good stuff. Acupressure. Hear me out, I'm not saying you should start sticking pins in your face to get more sleep. That would be acupuncture. Acupressure, on the other hand, is a Chinese alternative medicine technique which promotes relaxation by targeting specific pressure points that are located around the body. And it's totally painless too. There are various areas which you can stimulate while laying down to aid your sleep. The first is known as the spirit gate, which you'll find at the crease on your outer wrist, just below your pinky finger. Applying gentle pressure in this area, along with a circular or up and down motion for around 2 to 3 minutes, is supposed to quiet the mind to prepare it for sleep. Another relaxation point called the inner frontier gate is also located on your wrist, but this time you'll find it by counting 3 finger widths down from your wrist crease and applying a steady downward pressure between the 2 tendons. Finally, the wind pool, which is said to treat insomnia, is found on the back of your neck where the neck muscles attach to the skull. By interlocking your fingers together in a cup shape and using your thumbs to massage these points with a deep and firm pressure, you should feel your body relaxing as you exhale deeply. 4-7-8 breathing. If you're still counting sheep after changing exterior factors, there are plenty of sleep-saving breathing techniques out there. The 4-7-8 method was popularized by Dr. Andrew Weil, and if you can crack it, it's said to help you fall asleep in under 1 minute. To get going, you'll need to place the tip of your tongue against the ridge of tissue just behind your upper front teeth and keep it there as you follow these 4 simple steps. First, exhale through your mouth, making an audible whooshing sound. Then close your mouth and inhale quietly through your nose as you count to 4 in your head. Next, hold your breath for a count of 7. And finally, exhale completely through your mouth, making a whoosh sound as you count to 8. Once you've completed this cycle for 4 full breaths, you should feel relaxation coming on quickly, followed by the familiar feeling of sleep. The method is based on an ancient yoga technique called pranayama, which helps practitioners gain control over their breathing. Holding your breath for a period of time can give your organs and tissues a much-needed oxygen boost, bringing the body back into balance, which is particularly helpful if you're someone who lies awake worrying about the day ahead. Moon breathing. Most sleep hacks ask you to breathe slowly and deeply to take in as much oxygen as possible. But what if I told you closing one nostril could be just as effective? This idea comes from a Japanese technique known as moon breathing or chandra badana, which requires you to breathe exclusively from your left nostril. In her book Kaizen, the Japanese method for transforming habits one small step at a time, Sarah Harvey explains the simple steps to a great night's sleep. All you need to do is lie down, use your thumb to close your right nostril, and breathe deeply through your left. Then, briefly close your left nostril as you exhale through your right before closing it again. By repeating this action a few times, you should be able to regulate your breathing enough for your brain to feel less wired and more susceptible to sleep. In 2019, researchers at Trinity College Dublin discovered a link between regulated breathing and reduced production of a chemical messenger called noradrenaline, which is responsible for heightened emotions and increased blood pressure. Because the body's left side is often associated with the nervous system, focusing on it through chandra badana is supposed to calm it down and promote relaxation instead. The military trick. According to the 1981 book Relax and Win: Championship Performance, there's a handy trick used by the US military to help them fall asleep in just 2 minutes. Apparently, the technique was developed by the US Navy pre-flight school because too many fighter pilots were making terrible decisions in World War II due to stress and sleep deprivation. After just 6 weeks of practice, 96% of pilots could fall asleep even while sitting up in as little as 120 seconds. And you can too, as long as you follow these simple steps. First, you need to systematically relax your body. Breathe slowly and deeply, and focus on relaxing all 43 facial muscles by imagining your face tightening and relaxing, and your eyeballs sinking gradually into your sockets. Next, work your way down the body following the same process. Imagine each muscle tightening and relaxing from your shoulders down to your toes until you feel totally weightless. Once you've conquered your body, it's time to tackle your mind. Emptying your brain from all sorts of intrusive thoughts is easier said than done, but try to focus on your breathing as you visualize yourself in a calming location. That could be canoeing under a serene sky or relaxing in a velvet hammock, whatever floats your canoe. If that doesn't work, they suggest repeating "don't think, don't think, don't think" out loud 3 times. Seriously, give it a go yourself and let me know if it works. Dozed off yet? Did any of these simple sleep hacks work for you? Let me know in the comments below, and thanks for watching.